Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2408. Which Excel features do you avoid? Hey, this is more of my conversation with Anne K. Emery. Check out her blog at depictdatastudio.com/blog. Well, there's no better way than to get thousands of dislikes on a video than to talk about the things that I don't like. Because even if I don't like it, there's some large number of people out there that use these features all the time. And if it's a feature that's used by 1% of the Excel people, that's a stadium full of people who are going to be hacked off. But Ann asked me about the features that I'm not a fan of. So we're going to talk about the action pen, take a photo of a receipt and convert it to almost data. And the big one that's going to, I know, irritate everyone that I know, Ctrl+T tables. Plus, Ann talks about data bars with gradients. Let's get started.
Bill, what are some Excel features that you feel like aren't worth the hype? Maybe they take people a long time to learn. You know, there's a big learning curve, but maybe not as much payoff. Cool. Anything we should just not bother learning about and we can ignore and not feel bad?
There are ones you don't already know, right? Which is good, right? Like there's something called the action pen. The action pen is brand new and it lets you draw your data. So I can use a mouse or a pencil on an iPad and draw 1, 2, 3, and it'll convert it to 1, 2, 3, right? Which is the weirdest thing. Why did they waste any engineering cycles on letting me draw numbers when I have a keyboard? So the action pen, I'm just not a fan of the action pen. It's one of the silliest things I've seen in Excel.
I think this is only on the Excel app, like the phone app, but it's like you take a picture of a piece of paper and it converts the table. Does that work? Is that accurate?
It doesn't work at all, right? And here's the problem. Here's the problem. See this piece of paper? This piece of paper is perfect because it's never been folded. But the receipts that I get, everything does this, right? And once you fold that piece of paper, it never lays flat again. And now the problem that we have is the top half of this, the words are going that way, and the bottom half, the words are going that way. And if you fold the paper, it will not work. It's the worst thing. The stuff that they give you as a result of that, if you try and edit it, you should just start over from a blank sheet and type. I would even rather use the action pen rather than that, take a picture of the thing, because it's just terrible, right? And having 20% of the numbers wrong, that doesn't help me at all, right? I just become super nervous about the data. So yeah, not a fan.
So as a broke college student, I didn't want to pay for photocopying in my university library. So I was doing a research project on like something where I was looking at all these books. I think they were too heavy to check out. So I brought my camera, which was like this big at the time. This was before smartphones. And I remember taking pictures of data tables in books in the university library. And then later, like, looking at the numbers of tables. So when Excel came out with that thing, like just take a picture, scan your table and it fills into a spreadsheet. I was like, I lost a whole weekend of my life typing in numbers, but I'm actually really relieved that you're saying it doesn't really work very good because, you know, and these are books that when you open them, they're not flat. They have that kind of curve in the middle anyway. So
yeah.
So my life wasn't totally wasted.
I have a scanner over there that deals with that curve. It's all about the curve. And I have someone that I ran into a seminar gave me 120 copies of Lotus 1, 2, 3 magazine, which was a thing back in the 80s. And I started out scanning all of those issues of Lotus magazine, but then I got like 6 issues in and stopped. I have no idea what that story has to do with anything.
You don't still have those magazines sitting around?
No, they're right there. And it's actually, it was wild to look at what was amazing in 1986. What new feature had just come along that they were like, you know, like fill, type in January and grab the thing and have it fill February, March, like that was brand new. And there was someone who was selling a foot mouse, right? So that way you could use your hands to type, but then your foot to click, right? Like that was a big thing. They advertised six issues in a row or something like that. They still sell it. Like you can still buy a foot mouse if you need to be able to work faster, I guess. I have no idea. It's crazy.
I'm not that coordinated. I'm picturing like a drummer at a drum set who's like able to go like this at the same time with a little foot pedal.
Yeah, exactly.
I can't do that. Right.
right? And now that formula has to get copied down. And I don't use tables. I don't press Ctrl+T ever.
Tell me more about tables, because I don't use tables either. I was never taught to use them.
High five. Let's
yeah, just work. Okay.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
By the time I realized what Excel tables were, I feel like it was almost too late for me to start using them.
Good,
but then
you.
I kind of figured out their ins and outs. So I wasn't so wowed, but tell me more about this.
Yeah, so I hate tables because it turns off several features, deep features, but features that I use all the time. You can't do subtotals. On the data tab, there's a subtotal command on the far right-hand side, and I love subtotals. When I used to work using Excel 40 hours a week, I would use subtotals every single day. They were one of my core go-to features. You know, when I didn't need a pivot table, subtotals would do it. And those don't work with tables, so that irritates me. Custom views is a feature that is great for hiding and unhiding sheets. And today I get it, we can unhide all the sheets at once, but it used to be that you can only unhide one sheet. So I would use custom views for that. Those don't work with tables. And I'm still annoyed that when I want to copy two sheets from this workbook to another workbook, you can't do it if there's a table on both sheets. Like, what's their problem? So for me, I just reject tables. And I've run into a lot of people now who are giving me a lot of heat over that. They're like, what do you mean you don't use tables? Tables are the greatest thing ever. I'm like, man, not to me. Sorry.
Does anybody else here want to share one of your favorites, like a favorite go-to Excel technique? I'm going to say mine are pivot tables, lookups, and I love my conditional formatting. I think I joke in this course. I'm like, click on Anne's favorite button of all time, conditional formatting. I'm a visual person, of course, so I love my data bars and my heat maps.
Oh yeah, that's good. Do you have any problem? So when data bars first came out, there were a bunch of visualization people who were very antagonistic about data bars, that they, like at zero, they actually showed a little bit of color at zero, and that the gradient was irritating people. I'm like, no, these are cool, right? What are you all upset about? This is a great feature. What's your opinion? Do you have any problems with that?
I have a blog post called 24 conditional formatting features that should be retired from Excel. I love the solid fill ones. I use the solid fill data bars all the time. I'm not a fan of the gradients, because if you're supposed to compare the lengths of the bars, but they fizzle out towards the end, how do you see it? So no, but I use them all the time. And hopefully people in this course have gotten to those lessons so far. I use them in dashboards, I think I use them every single day. So those are a good one if people haven't discovered them yet.